from WHDH-TV Boston. This is News 7 at 5:30. The opening of the Holocaust Memorial Museum in Washington, dedicated to teaching the world why one chapter of history should never again be repeated.
But first, our top story, the sale of WHDH-TV, Channel 7. A Massachusetts native is set to take the reins, saying the commitment to news and the community will continue. Good evening. The sale is still subject to approval by the Federal Communications Commission.
Channel 7 owner David Mugar announced the sale this afternoon. Our business editor, Marianne Kane, tells us what's behind the sale and what it means to you, our viewers.
A change of ownership at WHDH-TV. Owner David Mugar sold the station for $215 million cash to Ed Ansin, who owns the number one TV station in Miami. For Boston viewers, this means more news.
The emphasis will be on developing a strong news franchise and a competitive news program that the viewers in Boston will like.
Ansin and Mugar are two of only four individuals who own TV stations in major markets. The rest are owned by groups. Ansin has owned WSVN in Miami for 30 years through his Sunbeam Television Corporation and offers viewers 7 hours of local news a day.
Stop holding your breath. The man who would be king won't.
Some criticize the tabloid approach that has brought Ansin success in Miami.
Boston and Miami are totally different markets. I don't think there's going to be a whole lot of similarity between the news on this station and the news as you see it in Miami.
For David Mugar, it's the end of an era. The heir to the Star Market fortune, he was awarded the station back in 1982 after RKO lost the license. It was to be a new day dawning.
Welcome to WNEV-TV's first day of broadcast service to the New England community.
But the road for WNEV, which was later renamed WHDH, was rocky. It took years to build credibility, but with the recent recession, advertising in the region plunged. The station was hit hard financially. In the last 2 years, through cost-cutting and aggressive sales, the station has been making money. But WHDH carried a heavy debt load because of partner buyouts. Despite a recent refinancing, David Mugar decided to sell because the deal was right.
Do you come out with a profit or a loss from this investment of yours over the last 11 years with this deal?
We come out on the profitable side for all the shareholders.
So it was a good investment?
It was a very good investment, and more than anything, it was a great honor to have the public trust of owning a television station in your own community.
Analysts believe that the sale of Channel 7 heralds the sale of media properties again. They are looking very lucrative because of changes at the FCC and the explosion in multimedia communications. This is a case of when we are the news here tonight.
Yes. Yeah. What about timing here? How do you explain that?
Very interesting. David Mugar told me had he sold our station 2 years ago, it would have commanded about $130 million. He would have had a significant loss. By selling it now when the station is moving forward financially and the economy is also starting to move forward financially, he gets $215 million cash and he makes money. So the timing for him is very, very significant.
FCC approval required here. How far down the road?
Late summer, late August, early September.
Okay. Thank you, Marianne Kane, our business editor.
Eyewitness News continues with Liz Walker and Randy Price.
There's a new owner coming to the CBS television affiliate here in Boston. Officials today announcing WHDH-TV Channel 7 is being sold to the Sunbeam, a television corporation based in Florida. The station made the announcement at 2 this afternoon. David Mugar, the current owner of Channel 7, says he is extremely gratified with the accomplishments of the past 11 years. He says there is no good time to sell something you care for. But he says Sunbeam Television, owned by Massachusetts native Edmund Ansin, shares the station's commitment to Boston and to New England. Tonight on Eyewitness News at 6, Bill Shields will have more on the Channel 7 sale and what it will mean to the viewers.
The fundamental changes in broadcasting in this country means mm-hmm. that there will be less and less individual owners like this in the country. Mm-hmm. And I think that's a shame.
In any event, it's out with the old and in with the new. Viewers of Channel 7 will want to know if any changes are coming.
People can certainly expect changes, yes. The news will be somewhat different. It's not going to be the news product we have in Miami.
WSVN 7, Pitts, Sanchez, Daniels, Lovett. This is Channel 7 News at 6.
This is what Mr. Anson's people put on the air down in Miami. In the TV industry, his station is generally acknowledged to rely heavily on crime stories, the sensational, the bizarre, and of course, sex.
Are you a sexual intellectual? Most people think they are, when in fact, they're not. So let's find out. What do you know?
This is part of a graphic, explicit, five-part series on sex in the form of a quiz. Most industry analysts call this tabloid TV journalism.
And we have very attractive styling. Tabloid, in my view, means a lot of different things to a lot of different people. I would not call it tabloid, no.
You would call it what?
Attractive.
One Channel 7 news employee said late this afternoon, "I don't know whether to be happy or sad. I'm happy because it looks like we all have more job security, but I'm not at all certain I want to do tabloid journalism." At Channel 7 in downtown Boston, Kirby Perkins, News Center 5.
Well, Boston's media community is certainly buzzing tonight about some big changes on the scene. Channel 7 now has a new owner. Eyewitness News reporter Bill Shields tells us the man who purchased Boston's CBS affiliate has some local ties.
There have been name changes, management changes, and now Channel 7 will have a new owner. This man, Edmund Ansin.
This station has a very strong programming schedule. It has a CBS network, has Wheel and Jeopardy. David Letterman show is coming in later this year. What we plan to add is a stronger news franchise.
Ansin owns Sunbeam Broadcasting, one TV station in Miami. But he's originally from the Boston area. Now he's coming back to New England with a short track record of bringing tabloid news to South Florida.
Talking about more newscasts and newscasts which are produced in a manner which is more appealing to viewers.
Since 1982, David Mugar has struggled to make Channel 7 number one in the very competitive Boston TV market. After a decade of some wins and some losses, Mugar decided the time was right to leave his broadcasting venture.
There are many advantages to owning a single station, and especially in your own hometown, but there's a great disadvantage, and that is if you have a problem like we've had in the Massachusetts economy starting 4 or 5 years ago, there's no place to spread that risk.
And TV critic Monica Collins says the station's new owner is promising an influx of cash, and the money could translate into new muscle for the struggling TV station.
It will bring more news trucks, which the station needs. It will bring more staff, which the station needs. And it brings new hope, let's hope, for the people who are working here.
Employees were told today that they would soon have a new boss who's promising more money, more staff, and more news.
Looks like the future is going to be more competitive with the other two stations, and we're going to be out there probably doing the job and maybe moving up in the ratings, we hope.
Bill Shields, TV4 Eyewitness News.